No doubt, most of you have heard of the film or even seen the film Enemy at the Gates, the story of the Russian sniper Vasily Zaitsev, who is thrown into the Stalingrad horror show only to become Russia's premium sniper, subjected to a massive propaganda campaign which raises his awareness to the Germans, who in turn send across their own prima sniper, Major Koenig, to carry out a sniper duel, which Zaitsev eventually wins because he is morally correct.
Wow, that's the Hollywood version anyway.
There is some truth, however, to the movie. Zaitsev was born into a peasant family in the Urals, and growing up he was taught hunting and marksmanship by his grandfather and older brother. The first thing his grandfather taught him was that of patience, a must if you want to be a sniper, bagging apparently his first trophy kill at the age of 12, that of a wolf. The main lesson he says he learnt from his grandfather was that of patience, which made him invisible, something Zaitsev would continually stress throughout his career, whereby he would say, "Time for me does not exist. A sniper needs to become invisible." Zaitsev started his military career in the Navy as a finance officer, oddly enough, and he requested on numerous occasions to be transferred to frontline duties, a wish that was finally granted in 1942 when he was transferred to Stalingrad. Like the majority who travelled into Stalingrad at that time, he did so by boat across the Volga. But unlike the movie version, he did not go across unarmed, and he was not thrown into a mass attack immediately. At first he was just another soldier and was caught up in the horror of hand-to-hand combat, like most were in Stalingrad, even getting wounded by a bayonet stab in one such hand-to-hand encounter. He eventually became to prominence when he took out a German soldier at over 800 meters and within a month taking out 32 enemy soldiers, earning him a bravery medal, all without a sniper scope. At the same time as he got the bravery medal, however, he was awarded a sniper scope to go with his normal Mosin-Nagant rifle. The fighting in Stalingrad was effectively hell on earth, and word got around of this undefeated, indestructible sniper, and he became a soldier's hero. One of the more notorious stories of Zaitsev is his infamous duel with Erwin Koenig, a major from the German sniper school, allegedly the best sniper in the whole of Germany. Zaitsev himself refers to this in numerous occasions in his memoirs and in a TV documentary, where it is claimed that Koenig was sent across by the Germans to effectively defeat Zaitsev. And Zaitsev says that they then went into a 3-day duel that Zaitsev eventually won. However, there is some dispute as to the authenticity of this story, on the grounds there are no records within the German archives of any soldier called Erwin Koenig being their premium sniper being sent to Stalingrad. The story itself was immortalized in the book by William Craig in 1973 called Enemy at the Gates. But again, it's highly unlikely that an American author in that period of time would have had access to the Russian archives and was basing what he was writing about on the propaganda at the time. More recently, the historian Anthony Beaver, in his book Stalingrad, has cast further doubt on the story, and he has had access to the Russian archives, because there is no mention of this so-called duel in any of the battle reports that were sent from the Stalingrad front back to Moscow, leading many to argue that this is actually a propaganda creation and not a true story. Eventually, however, Zaitsev was wounded in a mortar attack at Stalingrad and removed from the front, whereby he was awarded the Hero of the Soviet Union Medal in 1943 for his actions within Stalingrad. He eventually recovered and returned to active frontline duty, taking part in the Battle of the Zelau Heights, the Red Army's prelude to the Battle of Berlin. After the war, he became the head of the Soviet Sniper School, where he taught the Sixes, a sniper tactic that he invented in Stalingrad, and is still taught and used today. Zaitsev himself died in 1992 and was buried with full military honours in what is modern-day Volgograd, at a place called the Mamayev Kurgan. as befitting a hero of the Soviet Union. As a sniper, Zaitsev is credited with 240 kills, of which 225 were made in Stalingrad. This number is actually pretty average for an effective marksman, and his exploits appear to have been boosted by propaganda in order to buoy up morale in Stalingrad. Whatever the truth may be about Zaitsev and his duel with Erwin Koenig, none can argue his courage and skill during what could only be described as one of, if not the most horrific battle during World War II. And whilst he may have been subject to overzealous Soviet propaganda during the war and immediately after it, it could be seen that in this instance, there is some justification for blowing Zaitsev's trumpet. Whatever the true story may be, Zaitsev was himself a remarkable sniper, a hero of the Soviet Union, despite the overzealous propaganda. I have been Fugit. That has been a brief look at the real Vasily Zaitsev, the star of the movie Enemy at the Gates, where he's played by Jude Law. By all means, comment, like, and everything below. If you haven't yet subscribed, please do so. And I'd like to give a big shout out to my Patreons, who, without their support, these videos would be a lot harder. There will be more updates coming soon on history. They come out every Tuesday. So until then, guys, stay safe and catch you again later.